Father and our God, we bless your name as we go into your word again today. Father, as I open my mouth, send forth your word with power. Let it save the souls of the children of men into your kingdom. In Jesus' name I pray. Today we shall continue with our discussion on walking in love with your parents. Hallelujah. Today let's begin with Proverbs 17 verse 25. I read from the King James Version. A foolish son is a grief to his father and bitterness to her that bear him. Now, who is a foolish son? Whether foolish son or foolish daughter is the same. Any child, any boy or girl, any son, any daughter that fails to heed the teachings of the Holy Scriptures, that fails to follow the good counsel of the parents, that chooses to disobey the law of his father and the law of his mother, invariably becomes a foolish son or a foolish daughter. And these are the kind of children who cause sorrow of heart for their parents, father and mother. These are sons and daughters who fail to grow up to become responsible people, who become school dropouts, university dropouts, drug addicts, girls who carry unwanted pregnancy, political thugs, harlots, thieves, drunkards, street fighters, and all such things. No parent can have his children in any of these positions and be happy. No normal parent can be glad about it. That's why the Bible says a foolish son is a grief to his father and bitterness to her that bear him. And I've told you, not son alone. Likewise, a foolish daughter is a grief to her father and bitterness to her that bear her. Hallelujah. So children and people of God, don't allow yourself to be in any of these situations. Don't allow yourself to be in any of these positions. And if you are presently, stand up like the prodigal son did and go back home. Stand up like the prodigal son did and go back to your father and submit yourself to the instructions of your father and your mother. Repent from every evil and God will give you a great and beautiful turnaround. And he will make your life beautiful and make your life great to the glory of his holy name. Hallelujah. And any of you parents that have children in any of these conditions or positions, I pray the power of the Holy Ghost will touch them and bring them to repentance and make their lives beautiful such that they will become sources of joy and gladness for you in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Proverbs chapter 19 verse 13. A foolish son is the calamity of his father and the contentions of a wife are a continual dropping. The scripture here compares two things that are evil or difficult for a man to bear, the agony of a foolish son and the trouble of a wife that is full of contentions, always complaining, always quarreling. The Bible is saying both are evil and no man can be happy with either of the two or both of the two. So if you are a son, don't be a source of calamity to your father. You are a wife, don't be a source of trouble as of a continual dropping for your husband. All the young people hearing me today, I want you to determine that you be a source of joy and not calamity to your father, to your mother, and you will live to the glory of God. And that you be a source of joy above all to Christ and not a source of calamity to God. Hallelujah. You read Genesis chapter 6 reveals to us that God is unhappy when he beholds the children of men living wayward lives, living in violence, living in iniquity, and doing things that are contrary to the will of God. So don't make yourself like that. Be a child, a son, a daughter that makes the father and mother glad and that makes God glad at the same time. Hallelujah. Look at Genesis chapter 6 verse 6. I read, "And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. Don't be among those whose lives grieve the Lord. Don't be among the boys and girls, sons and daughters, whose lives cause calamity for their parents and for the Father in heaven. Make up your mind today to quit every ungodliness and every riotous living, every careless living, and to begin to live in obedience to the wisdom of God as found in the Holy Scriptures, and to become a source of gladness and joy to your father, to your mother, and above all, to your heavenly Father. Hallelujah. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 23, verses 24 to 25. The father of the righteous shall greatly rejoice, and he that begetteth a wise child shall have joy of him. Thy father and thy mother shall be glad, and she that bare thee shall rejoice. Hallelujah. I pray that this will be the portion of every boy or girl, every son and daughter hearing me today. And I pray also that this will be the portion of parents who have boys or girls, sons or daughters. I pray God will transform the lives of their sons and daughters to be righteous people and people that make father and mother glad. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's go on to Proverbs 29 verse 3. Whoso loveth wisdom rejoiceth his father, but he that keepeth company with harlots spendeth his substance. Hallelujah. This scripture is teaching you to walk in wisdom, to walk in the light of God, in the Holy Scriptures. And he's saying if you walk in wisdom, you become a successful person that makes his father and mother glad, and that makes the heavenly Father glad also, because he walks in righteousness. Hallelujah. But if you choose to keep the company of harlots and drug addicts and violent people, it will be to your ruination, because that's not good for you. Will make your father or your mother full of sorrow. But at the same time, don't forget, it's your life. You are the one that will bear much of the sorrow later in life. When your parents get old, they will go away from the earth and leave you here. And you continue to suffer the consequences of your bad choices, the consequences of your riotous living and careless living. Hallelujah. So it's better for you to repent now. It's the way you are going to show that you love God and that you love your parents, by walking in obedience to the commandments of God that he has laid down in the Holy Scriptures concerning how children should relate with their parents. Hallelujah. Proverbs 28 verse 7, whoso keepeth the law is a wise son, but he that is a companion of riotous men shameth his father. So young man, young lady, be a wise son, be a wise daughter. Keep the law of God. Walk in the light of the Scriptures. Don't be a companion of riotous men or women. Don't be a companion of riotous boys and girls or riotous young men and women. Give yourself to the Holy Spirit so that you can be a wise son and a wise daughter that live to the expectation of the Holy Scriptures, that make their parents glad, and above all, that makes the Heavenly Father glad. Hallelujah. Let's go on to Proverbs 28 verse 24. I read, whoso robbeth his father or his mother and saith, it is no transgression, the same is the companion of a destroyer. Hallelujah. Never rob your father. Never rob your mother. It is a great evil before God. Never be a robber. Don't rob anybody. But there are some people who will not rob outside because they are afraid of going to prison. They won't rob anybody outside. But what they cannot do to people outside, because they don't want to be arrested by police and be taken to court and be put in jail finally, they do it to their father and their mother. They think because it's their father, because it's their mother, they think they are free to do what they like with their property or with their money. They think they are free to steal from father or mother. Not by gun, not at gunpoint, but by cunning methods, by cunning ways of living or of doing things, by deception. They rob their father. They steal from father. They steal from mother. By trickery, by deception, or when the father is not observing or the mother is not observing, or by lying. Daddy, let me help you to buy this. I'll help you to do the shopping. And they inflate what they buy and steal from their father, steal from their mother. That's evil. The Bible says it is a great evil. The person who does that is the companion of a destroyer. He's as bad as an armed robber who stays on the road to rob people going by. His wickedness is even greater because he does evil to a father and a mother who have labored to make his life good, even though he never cooperated. But they still labored, and it's in the record of God that they labored. Hallelujah. Young man, young woman, never be in this situation. And if you are, repent right away. Repent today. Turn away from your iniquities. Surrender your life to Jesus. The blood of Jesus is still available. It's always flowing. It's ever flowing to save the souls of those who turn to him. Be among those who will return to God today and call on Jesus to transform your life, and he will do so. Open the door of your heart for Jesus to come in and repent from all your iniquities so that your life can be beautiful both in this world and in the world to come. Repent today before it is too late. Turn away from all your iniquities. Remember that Christ died for you. He loves you to the extent that he died for your sins, and he wants you to turn to him today in total repentance. Why not do so today? There is no need for another delay. Don't delay one more second. Turn away from your iniquities and return to Jesus Christ today. Hallelujah. And he will receive you, and he will forgive your sins. He will wash away your iniquities. He will make your life beautiful, both for now and the future, both in this world and in the world to come. Hallelujah. Turn away from every bad companionship today, because the Bible says evil companionship will destroy your character. Let's see 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 33. I read, "Be not deceived. Evil communications corrupt good manners." Hallelujah. I read also from Modern King James Version. "Do not be deceived. Evil companionships corrupt good habits." I read from Montgomery's New Testament. "Do not deceive yourselves. Evil companions ruin good morals." Hallelujah. So, brother, sister, turn away from bad boys and bad girls and return to Jesus today and allow him to give you good friends that are children of God, that are righteous people walking in the way of righteousness. And God will make your life beautiful, both for now and the future. And above all, you'll be able to inherit the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. We stop here for today. Father in heaven, what are the words in the hearts of the people? Let it save their souls into your kingdom. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen.
This Word of Life program is coming to you through the mouth of God's servant, Oluwa Bamishi Akinduro of the Triumphant Church of Jesus Christ at 66A Lagos Abeokuta Expressway, Abekoko, Ifo, Ogun State, Nigeria. For further Christian life help, contact 0805-501-6597, 0805-501-6597 by SMS or WhatsApp, or email oluwabamisheakinduro@gmail.com, oluwabamisheakinduro@gmail.com, oluwabamisheakinduro@gmail.com. You can also call 003-842-4075, 003-842-4075, or 003-695-4678, 003-695-4678.
Copies of this short sermon and other longer sermons in English language only can be sent to you free of charge by WhatsApp or email if you request for them.
Join us for this Word of Life program, same day of the week, same time every week. Our Sunday morning service starts at 9 a.m. You are invited to fellowship with us. Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen and amen.